Hey guys, Frostbeard, welcome back to a little vibe game commentary. Today we're playing some Rengar jungle. I'm not particularly good at Rengar, but I kind of enjoy playing him and sort of wanting to get better at him because he's, I think he has potential in solo queue. I think if you're good on Rengar and you play him well, he's actually really strong. So that's why I wanted to play some Rengar today. Just fancy playing him, you know how it is. Before we're tryharding for that elo, let's play some things that we enjoy playing. I've had to start this game with a slash mute all. If you take a look at my score, I died trying to defend LeBlanc from the level 1 invade, which is not great, but then I got flamed for it. So yeah, it was pretty bad all in all, and I'm not in the mood for being, well, I'm not in the mood for it. I know that, you know, I'm gonna like, that's something that tilts you, right? When you save someone and then they start, yeah, I'm raging at you. So I've just muted everyone because we're just gonna be playing like a farm focus game today, guys. Rengar, I think, operates best playing that kind of style. But you have to be careful with Rengar because your early clear, you do get pretty low. You do have good AoE, so you can do things like chicken camp quite easily. But like I say, if you get low, then you're kind of vulnerable too. So enemy jungler is Nocturne this game. I don't have my flash, so doing this is actually pretty risky. But hopefully I get away with it. And Nocturne doesn't walk over the... Oh, here. He's actually topside, so that's fine. Almost. Ah, he misses the Q! Unlucky. Is he coming down here, really? Holy shit, no way. Nice. Good shit, we got him. Alright, let's see if I can get mid here without dying. What do you reckon, lads? I'm pretty low. I would like to do something here, but I don't know. This guy has no flash, though, I remember. He flashed to finish me off. Jax and Malzahar both flashed. Warded, and I'm... Whoops, I'm not recording. You know what? I'm actually going to go for the Krugs here first. I don't want to smite these though, and I'm probably only going to take the first two, like the these two here. Okay, I don't want to die though, so we'll smite it. I'm going to leave these because they just take too long to kill, so I'm just going to leave them. Let them despawn, and then we'll take Krugs when they come up properly next time around. I totally forgot to mention this, by the way, guys, but something that I wanted to talk about here. Concerning the last game that I played on this channel. Wait, actually, there's two things I need to say here. Holy shit. So, first thing I want to say, on my main channel, I don't know when I'm going to release it, either today or tomorrow, but I've got a game that I played on this account where I played Zac. So I really want to get a Zac gameplay on my main channel, but it's so difficult to do it because he's banned all the time. So, I finally got a gameplay with Zac, so I put that on my main channel. So, you kind of like missed a game, I guess, but it doesn't really mean much because it was just like, you know, it's not like a promo game or anything like that. And we lost it though, sadly. Probably, you know, if you hadn't seen it yet, maybe that was a spoiler, but we did lose. So we're like 50 LP or something like that now. But also, something I want to address here is talking about my last gameplay when I was doing my promos and I was playing Warwick. So I had a bit of an unfortunate game where we lost the promos again. But my personal performance, like, I feel like it was okay. I mean, we had like 3 mid towers by 15 minutes. Like, I think that's pretty decent. However, it wasn't like great, I would say. Like, I definitely didn't play perfectly or anything like that. And I just kind of want to say that I was pretty salty at the end of that game because I lost and I keep losing my promos. And I will be 100% honest, I don't feel like I was, you know, like the worst jungler. I don't feel like I was out jungled or anything, if that makes sense. So it kind of sucks to lose. But regardless, what I want to say is that I looked at the comments after that, like the other day. And the comments were like, some of them were okay. Most of them though, I would say there was like a few nice comments, but there were actually quite a lot of like negative comments in there. people hating on me and stuff, which is fair enough, you know, like, if that's your jam, that's your jam. But I just want to say, like, because I know your immediate reaction to this is you guys are going to say something like, oh, don't listen to the comments, you know, just do your own thing, etc., which is true, but I just kind of wanted to apologize because I did kind of get salty, and I believe that the community that you have on whatever platform you have is usually a pretty good reflection of how you are personally. So if you are toxic or negative or salty or whatever, then your community gets toxic, salty, and negative. So normally my communities are pretty good. Like on Twitch, it's really good. On YouTube, it's really good. But this time around, not so much. But that, I think that was pretty much my fault. So sorry for that, guys. I'll try not to be so salty, but I hope you understand the frustrations, I guess, it can be in a situation like that. Alright, I literally tanked one. Oh, wait, was it actually maybe two abilities from Miles there? Two abilities from Miles and I'm out. Goodbye. Alright, let's try and go topside here. Like, I think literally every lane right here has pinged me for help, so, like, in the last 20 seconds. It's kind of annoying. It's like, guys, just do your own shit, and then if I'm there, I'm there. If not, I'm not. I missed that. I missed it. As soon as I threw it, I knew I missed that shit. Alright, well, at least he's dead. I missed my E. Like a boosted bonobo. Good shit. I get a lot of CSS, so that's actually not too bad. From a greedy perspective, that's actually not that bad. Okay, and we're getting more of these Rengar stacks here. I'm focusing on farming, but we're getting some stacks, which is really nice. I should have gone in here earlier. Did he ult LeBlanc clone there? Please die! What the fuck? Holy fuck, I should have used my empowered Q. Ah, that's so annoying! Maybe I should. No, I shouldn't have used my empowered E when I initiated, though. Like, I wasn't gonna hit him with that. Because if he has both his summoners up, then if I use my empowered E, I don't think it changes anything. You know what? I'm gonna do a different build this game. So I saw someone do this build when I was playing. Was it when I was streaming, maybe? Maybe it was on my main account, I don't know. But this, like, Rengar one trick, he was obviously smurfing with, like, a 70 or 80% win rate or something. He went for this build here. Basically, you just go pretty tanky. Let's stop. You basically just go pretty tanky. It's really, it's quite interesting, and then you just out-damage people. Like, you can still be an assassin, you just don't kill people as fast. And you focus more on, like, bullying people and stuff. So I'm going to do that shit here. I do want to go for, like, CDR, I guess. But for now, I'm just going to go for this build. Let's see if we can just run it mid and see if we can get this guy. I think he's actually dead. He is dead. Fair enough. See if we can get something in this guy's jungle. God damn it, it's not up. He's getting the skull there. Is this up here? It is. Good shit. I'll go mid. I'll go bot after this. I kind of want to wait for my ulti. So I'm just going to just be patient, lads. I'll be there in a jiffy. Just hold on, okay? And they're under the tower. I mean, I have to wait for my ult. I can't just walk up behind them. But, yeah, that kind of relies on not pushing. Nice, he's going bot side here. Nice. So is that... Do I have stacks now on everyone but bot lane? I think that's the case here. Pretty sure. And taking away this guy's bot side jungle was so good for me. Like, I got half a level and he misses all that experience as well. So basically, if you think about it, I kind of got like, you kind of get like double the experience if you counter jungle something, because not only do you get it, but you take it away from the enemy. So it's a nice ping, mate, but I don't have my ulti. I mean, you don't need your ult, or you know, it's not like you just lose your limbs if you don't have your ultimate, but it's a very different kind of game, you know, if you're playing Rengar without your ult up. Oh shit, I hit him. Nice. Wait, my red buff got him? I might be able to go for Herald here. Gonna try Herald. I haven't mentioned my Runes and Masteries this game though, guys, but sorry about that. But I'm 80 reds, attack speed quints, arm yellows, and MR blues. And for Masteries, I've gone for Storm Raiders this game. Like, you can, like, 12-18 with Storm Raiders. You can go for Thunderlords if you want as well on Rengar, but I think if you go Storm Raiders, then it's kind of better later on when you just, like, when you have enough damage, you just gotta get close to people. Please don't say that's me. Thank God for that. That's bot lane, but he actually failed it, so that's cool. Does he want that? Nope. That's fine. Alright, let's get out of here. We'll go for the Cinderhawk here, and Ninja Tabby is what we'll go for boots. We do need some CDR though. We have like no CDR right now outside of our Masteries, which kind of sucks. I kind of want to put the Rift Herald mid lane low. If I do that, we're not going to get first by tower. That's too late. Is he dead? He is dead. Can I get Sivir? What do you reckon, lads? Why does my mouse keep fucking bugging out? Nah. It's a shame. I almost got in on that one, but not quite. Maybe I should have put the Rift Herald mid actually here. I was going to put it mid because Miles went bot, but then I was like caught in two minds about actually going bot lane there. I think I should have gone mid and just put it down there. I am 2 levels up on bot lane though, which is pretty good. I'm pretty high level in general actually. I've still got my ward up in Nocturne's jungle here, so I don't need to replace my control ward. You want to dive that shit? We can dive that shit, I guess. This is a Rift Herald play if ever I've seen one, though. Hitting the laner, everyone's visible on other sides of the map. That is a Rift Herald play. Good shit. We can probably get the second tower here as well. Oh wait, is that control warded? I don't think we should keep going. I think that's a bad idea. I'm pretty sure this is control warded though. I don't know how Nocturne saw that if this wasn't control warded. Wait, how did he see that? How did he saw? He doesn't have a sweeper. How did he legit see that? What the hell? Oh, did he? He must have used the Scryers, I guess. Scryers Bloom. Okay, we need to be careful here. Okay, thank God this just spawned. I was going to say, like, we are 100% getting ganked here. Look at that E! What a beast! Holy shit. That predictive E. Good shit. Why does my mouse keep doing this, man? Okay, now we're in trouble, though. Bloody hell. Woofed. That weren't good. I need to find out what's going on with my mouse, man. Why does my mouse keep doing this shit? It keeps, like, tabbing me out. It's not good shit, yo. It's distracting. Alright, let's go for the cleaver next, guys. I should probably go cleaver instead of the phage here. What's it gonna be, mate? I'm close to level 11 as well, which is that's the shit I like. Yeah, Trindamin, mate. He's got his eyes on the prize, isn't he? Blimey. I don't think I can run someone down here necessarily, though. I can try, but I don't think I'll be able to. I should probably be taxing lanes a little harder as well. There's no real reason why Nocturne should be a higher level than me. He's not... Well, like, he was level 11 before that play even happened, right? So... No, fuck my life. I knew that was going to happen. Did I actually need that for 11 here as well? I think I did. Because now I have to take the Gromp. It's not just going to be her here, right? Holy fuck. Fuck. I should have used the blast cone. God damn, we're getting rinsed, lads. What's going down? This ain't good. This is pretty bad. Okay. Going for the old Cleaver next. I got level 11 at least, so that shit's good. Being level 11 means my ulti has a much lower cooldown. I really want to kill bot lane though. Get these two stacks going. But it's not happening, is it? I accidentally used that control ward as well. Because that slot there is bound to a mouse button. And I accidentally, when I was like panicking with my mouse, I accidentally clicked the button. Ugh, god damn. Well, at least I know why I don't play Rengar. If you guys ever wondered why I don't play Rengar, wonder no longer. If Lebron comes in here, or anyone comes in here, this guy's dead, so... Interesting. Nice, I'm gonna get some farm, guys. I'm gonna get some farm. Yes, it's gonna happen. I'm gonna keep going here, I think. There's only Sivir, Jax, and Morgana alive. And we saw Jax topside. I guess I could get goon squatted here, but... I'll get the farm, so it's worth it, right? Oh my god. I can't believe I forgot this doesn't build into Black Cleaver anymore. Fuck my life. Well, it still goes into Death's Dance. I guess we can do that, right? I was thinking, I was like, god, 2.6k? God, it's so expensive still. Oh my goodness, that's like a season 6 thing, right? Maybe season 5 even. I don't know. That's dumb though. That's not good. God damn, how'd I forget that shit? God damn. That's okay though. Like I say, Death Dance is still pretty good on Rengar. Especially like a semi-tanky Rengar. Although it's not really what I was aiming to go for. And I also don't think that I should have rushed the Cinderhulk this game. If I remember correctly, the guy that I was watching goes like Barmy Cinder and then just completely ignores Cinderhulk until quite late on into the game. I'm going to sit here and see if Jax keeps pushing.
Uh-oh. Get Jax. I am so fucked here. There was no way in hell I was surviving that shit. They can probably try that shit though, it's 3v3. And yeah. they had like a really good position to do that shit. If Zyra just puts down her abilities here, then that's such a free fight right there. They hesitated, lads. Hesitation is the seed of defeat. That's what Ahri says. Keep going, Jhin. Just attack him. You're dead. Like, you're 100% dead here. Oh my god. Literally auto attacks. Literally auto attacks. Ugh. I think he was one shot off of that, actually, wasn't he? He was pretty close. Woof. Tough one. We have a nice ward, though, on the Baron, so that's good shit. Don't think they'll be doing Baron just yet. This Malzahar is actually a huge pain in the ass. Considering he's 5... Well, Malzahar is actually the highest win rate mid laner, by the way, guys. Like, he's statistically very, very strong. But this game... this game especially, he's, like, really popping off. It's pretty scary. Alright, we got the Cleaver now. I really needed to get Cleaver here because I need the inventory slot for the control ward. Hello, the control ward. Thank you. I need the inventory slot for the vision here, so we'll go for the. Do I want to get Death Dance right now, or do I want to go for Titanic Hydra? I might just go for Titanic Hydra. Like, I don't think having the Warhammer in my inventory, even just by itself, is that bad. Honestly, I think that's cool. Is this so bad? I mean, there is four of us here. I feel like we could have done that, honestly. That's fine, though. Like, I use my ultimate. It has a fairly long cooldown, but... I guess it's not the end of the world. Let me go back here. I'm going to go for Titanic next, I think. Oh, shit. This is actually pretty good. Once Jax's Counter-Strike is down, he's honestly pretty weak. Ah, unlucky. There is the hunter and the hunted. Did Malzahar press R is the question. Because I would love to go in on this shit, but... If Mal's ult is up, I'm fucked. Fuck. Really? Okay. I mean, these 1-for-1 trades are okay for us, honestly. Considering we're behind in this game, trading 1-for-1 is not that bad. Like, the enemy team doesn't want to go 1-for-1 this game. The enemy team wants to actually punish us. And that involves actually, like... You know, if you're ahead, then trading 1-for-1 is pointless. Because then eventually, what's going to happen is... Like, say you're... Oh, God, that's a pretty big dragon to lose, though. Say you're, like, I don't know. Say you're 30 kills to 0. Holy crap, you're so far ahead. But if you keep trading 1-for-1, eventually you're going to be... 1,030,000 kills to 1,000,000, and then it doesn't matter, you know. The more you keep trading 1-for-1, the less it matters. Titanic is 2-3. I've got 1-3 right now. Multi's coming up though. Do I want to go bot lane here? I think I do actually. I pushed out mid just enough so that someone will most likely try and defend that shit. I did walk over a ward here, though. I seek only the strongest. I was hoping they weren't paying attention. All good, though. Let's try and use my control ward here. Can I actually get that Jax? He is pretty strong. LeBlanc's coming up as well, so. Where is she? There she is. Good shit. That's why you go tanky Jack, tanky Rengar as well. If I wasn't tanky there, that was like 100% donezo. The thing is as well with this bot lane, I don't really think we could defend this, right? Like, you may argue, oh, you went top, good job, but you're gonna lose. But it's like, well, could we really defend this? We just lost Tryndamere. Like, they've got... Like, how... What the fuck? That... Like, I don't... Okay. Don't wanna sound rude, but that was probably the worst thing I've seen in my life. Yo, these little voidlings are on my ass, man. Get off of me. Right, my ult is up here. Can I respawn? Home guards. Might be able to chase them down. Be a bit tricky, but it's a possibility. Never mind. Alright, lads. 150. That's what I need. I don't really know who the strong members of our team are this game. Who we should play around. Normally, obviously, it would be like your AD carry at this stage of the game, but this guy is... I don't know. And obviously, on top of that as well, your top laner, if it's someone like Tryndamere, would be someone you'd want to play around. But this guy's 1-9. So, it's tricky. I honestly don't know. I think Tryndamere is pretty strong. He's just like... I don't know. Just suiciding a lot. I don't really know what Jax is doing here, though. Does he really think he's going to get Nexus Towers by splitting bot? Like, for him, it would make more sense to split around, like, Baron or something. Oh, tanky Rengar hurts, man. Okay, nope. 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 Could have jumped to a minion there. And that ward as well. But I don't need it. Alright, nice. We got two kills there. That's good, right? I wonder if we can force a fight now. We need to fight now. If these guys overstay, we can kill them really easily here. Okay, Tryndamere just... God damn it, Tryndamere! We want to fight! A teleport though. I'm just gonna like suicide here, or if I do suicide, I don't mind. I should say. I'm gonna save my. Nice. Do I get all my stacks now? How have I only got 4 stacks? How did I not get both those stacks on Sivir and what's his face? We really need to turn here. If we don't turn here, this is a mistake. Good shit. Not great because we don't get the Baron there, so we basically just go 2 for 2, but... We had to turn, like... We can't just stay on the Baron when Nocturne's up. He will just take it. So, honestly, the mistake there is starting the Baron and then dedicating to it. I think we should have turned faster, but all in all, could have been worse. Again, we force a situation where we go even in kills, which I think is fine. We really should try and get this one, though, actually, this dragon. It's up in 40, though, which means it's going to be a 5v5 situation, which is not really something we want to go for. 5v5 situations are still a little bit for us. But I should be strong enough now to go for like Sivir or something, I think. If I find Sivir, I think I can kill her. How did I not get a stack on... Oh, wait. Okay, never mind. I didn't get a stack on Morgue because it has a cooldown, right? I forgot about that. It has a cooldown, so you can't get like loads of stacks in 1 second. So I still need to get Morg there, I guess. Holy shit. Is that... Wait, yeah, okay. I was gonna say, that has to be Dragon, right? We weren't really in a position to stop that one either, were we? Fuck my life. Oh well, level 16 here now, lads. That means I've got my rank 3 ulti, so it's almost up again. If I can find Sivir by herself, that's good shit. But they have 4 dragons, including 2 infernals, so... That's not good. That's not what you want to see. Not gonna lie. This could be good for us, actually, I think. They're pretty out of position here, I think. That was a bit too late, actually. I think we could have done something with that Jhin ult, but... I'd already tanked the Morgana binding. I don't have anything to get out of that shit, so... Holy shit, I have a lot of damage. Yeah, I see why this guy was going this build when he was smurfing. That's a free build right there. Whoops, that was my wrong... The wrong empowered ability there, but that's cool. Holy shit. We should get in here, but I think... Alright. If Tryndamere is going for Baron, just... We should just go for Baron, honestly. Like, what we do here... I don't know, it's like... You just have to do the same thing, I think. I don't really think it matters that much either, because... We're gonna get both anyway here, so... I think I need to go GA, actually, this game. I suddenly realized when I was in the fight there, I was like, GA would be really nice here. I actually like the ordering we did this. I think it's better to do the Baron first. Firstly, we didn't actually have any minions mid, so that kind of would have made things really difficult. But also, I think it's better to go for the Baron first, because then you can... like, that's the neutral objective, right? You can secure that. And then you just, you know, you're sorted. Like, that's the risky one, right? Now that Baron's dead, we can... And now we have Baron, we can group and actually do some good stuff. And probably get that mid inhibitor. Or something like that. Whereas that mid inhib being down would probably only get us, like... A shot at Baron, right? It's like, well... Why play for a shot at Baron when you can just, you know, get Baron? I'm actually going to sell this and go for the GA here. I think this is more important right now. I could also go Sterax instead of... where the fuck is... There it is. I could also go Sterax instead of Death's Dance. Which might be pretty good, honestly, considering how much... I actually... I don't know. No, I don't know. I think I... fuck, I don't know. That's tough. If I do that, though, I lose 10% CDR. Maybe I don't want to do that. I think I need a bit more damage, you know? Now, I'm really lacking resistances with this build. I have a lot of health, but not... fucking hell. Not a lot of resistances. I'm popping my ulti just because I don't know what that happened there. Look how much damage I have. Holy shit. How did she not die? Bugger. No, we'll go, we will go distance. I think we win this 2v2. I'm pretty sure we win this 2v2. Considering she just used her spell shield as well. If I can get her. Nah, she's got Moby, she's out. Well, maybe I can get her here. What the fuck is that fear? Do I need mercs? Holy moly. Disgusting. Couldn't quite get in on that. I'm sorry if I'm seeming like really quiet and stuff, by the way, guys. This is the second game in a row I've recorded. I'm feeling a little bit out of it, as you can probably tell. So my apologies, guys. How much is Death's Dance? 2-4. I need 1k gold, basically. This Malzahar is such a low level. Oh, actually, he's the same as LeBlanc. Fair enough. Oh, shit. That's a pretty risky face check. We have a nice split push from Trin, but why are you top? Why are you splitting top? That's not a useful split. You've already got the inhibitor and the towers. Like, what's the point of splitting? Oh, shit. Do I want to do this? Really? Holy shit. I thought we were just going to go hard there. I thought we were going hard in the paint, mate. I thought we were going for it. Fuck. That was so dumb. I shouldn't have done that. What am I doing? What am I doing? Fuck my life. I thought that would be a quite a sexy collapse. Jax wasn't in just yet. Pretty vulnerable. No front line. Small space for Zyra, but I just died instantly. Holy shit. I just died so fast. 2,000 damage from Sivir. Plus the suppression from Malzahar. Holy shit. I mean, we did get someone. I just thought... I don't know. I didn't think that one through. I did not think that one through. I thought we'd just jump in and it would just be, you know, fuck. Ah, goddamn. It has made me tempted to go for the go for the old sash, but I don't know. I'm not sure about that. It's not really that great for me, honestly. I guess like if Malzahar ults me in most situations, that's actually a good thing. It's only bad if I'm actually by myself, because if he uses his ult on me, then I think we win fights and stuff. So. We need to wait out Elder Dragon here. How long is it until it's down? It's halfway through. We can leave these inhibitors, that's fine. Holy shit, Sivir, bruv. Fuck my life, she hurts. I need a round of wins. And Jhin dies without his ult as well. Back. Yo, that's late game Sivir, man. Disgusting. Ah, man. We started off pretty poor. Then it went well. And then it just went to shit again. My suicide was really bad, though. That was pretty bad. I think we could have won that game. That was I got an S minus, yo. Good shit. Yeah, you can do good stuff and then just one bad thing and it's just like eh. Dunzo. If we'd won this game though, it would have been pretty impressive. I mean, look at that. Look at that shit. Whew. Alright, I'm gonna peace out, guys. Thanks so much for watching the gameplay, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry we couldn't put out Le Victoire, but yeah, not a great Rengar. I enjoyed the build, though. I think this build is pretty cool. Definitely could have played better. That's for shizzle. That's definitely just going to throw that one out there. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one. And I will see you in my next video.